Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch in the laws of vows and oaths. And he says, fascinating today. A person intends to designate for himself a certain amount of Torah that he wants to learn. Or a certain mitzvah that he wants to perform. And he's afraid that even though right now he's motivated, but maybe he's going to weaken and he's not going to fulfill it. Or he's in fear that perhaps the yetzahara, the evil inclination, will entice him to do something that is prohibited. Or the yetzahara is going to prevent him from doing some kind of a mitzvah. So in these cases, a person could then motivate himself by taking a vow or an oath. The Omer, like it says in the Gemara, how do we know that a person is allowed to take an oath to fulfill a mitzvah and to motivate himself, even though we already swore at Har Sinai, the giving of the Torah, that we're going to keep everything that it says in the Torah. So we already made a shavua, we already made a vow. Why are we now allowed to do it here? Shenemar, like it says, Nishbanti v'kaimo, Nishma mishmatei tzidkecha. I swore and I will fulfill to keep your righteous ordinances. And therefore, I'm allowed to swear. Even if you didn't say it in the language, the expression of a vow or an oath, rather it was an ordinary expression of intent. It has the status of a vow, and you have to keep it. And then he writes, therefore, a person has to be very careful. When he says he's going to do any mitzvah, he should say bli neder, which we learned before means without a vow. And that's the way a person should accustom himself. He should say bli neder whenever he says he's going to accept something on himself. He should say without a vow, so he's not bound to it. Even when a person's saying he's going to do something that's not a mitzvah, it's a devar reshus. It's an option that you could use. I'm going to go eat dinner right now. Even there, kadesh lo yikoshel chas v'sham ba'av in the darim, in order that you don't fall into the sin of violating vows, even there you should say, bli neder. I'm going to my car, and I'm going to drive down to the store and buy some food. Bli neder, because once you say that I'm going to do it, your words are binding, it sounds like a vow, and the only way that you will not be held accountable is if you say the famous words, bli neder. Okay, that's what we got up to today, and Be'ezah Hashem, we shall continue tomorrow.